Hey everyone, in this video of the series, we'll talk about the granularity of the table in data modeling. So let's start. So we'll start by defining what's a table. So table, you can see I've just queried on Google and says the data in RDF BMS is stored in objects, which is called a table. And it is basically a collection of related data entries, and it consists of numerous columns and rows. So that's what essentially a table is. And granularity of the table means how many columns you have in a table. So I'll explain this with a few examples. So let me open this, and this is, let me just put it into display mode. So when you're talking about granularity, either you can have less granularity or more granularity. So as you go from a less to more granularity, you will have more data. And similarly, aggregation is when you're summing data up. So you have, as you have more aggregation, the data points become less. And as you have less aggregation, you have more data points. So essentially, aggregation and granularity work in opposite directions. So we'll just quickly, as a concept, try to build a table. So I'll just drag a table here, and I'll put it into full screen mode. And what I will do is I will say, let's say we want to see order number. So we want to see the sales amount, and we want to see it by order year. And let me just go here, and I'll just say don't summarize, and let me just move it around. So it's showing me the sales amount by a year. So let's say that is the granularity of your table. So you can see over here that at a year granularity, the sales amount is very high. Now let's say I want to bring, let me just open order date, and I'll take this out. So we'll take order year out. We'll use the date hierarchy to understand this concept. So if I bring year here, you can see that the granularity, the aggregation level is very high, and it has very less granularity. So it is at a year granularity. Now let's say I bring in the quarter. So what happens then? When the moment I bring the quarter in, you can see that the number of rows has increased, and the sum values has decreased here on the sales amount column. So the aggregation has reduced and the number of rows has increased. So let's say if I bring month in, again we are increasing the granularity to a month level, which is essentially a more detailed level. And you can see that the aggregations again has the sales amount has reduced, and it is giving us the sales amount by year, quarter, month. And then if we bring day in, it will get further reduced. So aggregation is getting reduced and the number of rows we've got is increasing. So as we increase the granularity, the number of rows also increases. And if I wanted to add color as a granularity as well, so granularity is any column that I add which helps me in analysis of the data set. So let's say if I bring the color in as well, so it increases my granularity further. Now when you're defining your data model, essentially, or well, most times you want to get the data as the lowest level of granularity so you can roll up and roll down, so it enables analysis and helps you to figure out what is the main cause why something looks off. So for example, if 2010 has really less sales amount, what could be the reason? And you drill down further and you could see, hey, I didn't sell anything for the third quarter or the fourth quarter. So you, it helps you do detailed analysis, but there is a trade-off. So if you add more granularity, you can see that the number of rows increases. So how much data can your data model handle, or how much data do you want your data model to handle? So these are questions that you need to answer. So in this video, we've essentially covered what's the granularity and what's the aggregation levels, a couple of things that you need to consider. And as the granularity increases, or as you get more detailed granularity, the number of rows would go up. And as you reduce the granularity, the number of rows would shrink. So these are, so just wanted to cover granularity with this video. I hope you find this video useful, and thanks for watching this video. Please do subscribe to my channel and like my videos if you enjoy what I'm doing. Let me know if you would like me to take any specific topics around data modeling. Cheers, bye.